other term player, dragon, to be waiting for us later on, but we'll get there when we get there. In the bottom right-hand corner of the map, spawning all the way in the bottom right-hand corner, we have the blue Protoss player coming out from China. He is currently teamless. He is Firefly.
And spawning in the top left-hand corner of Romanticide LE, we have the Chinese Terran. The old guard himself, representing Team Invictus Gaming, it is XY.
The biggest wild card in just about all of this and everything. Mm-hmm. Not only because of how crazy his performance was last season, but also because he just has so many different play styles that can come out depending on what he needs to do.
Definitely. And I'm excited to see how he does against Firefly. Firefly, one of the younger players in the entire, you know, group stage here for China. So yeah, I mean, I was curious, XY, it looked like he was trying to scout for a proxy a little bit, but he ended up committing to an eBay block.
Not even going into the main base.
Yeah. Bold move.
Let's see if it pays off.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I guess he's hoping that his opponent doesn't proxy him or anything like that. There isn't like any missing buildings in the main base. But I mean, I'm sure XY is pretty familiar with Firefly. He's feeling confident.
Yeah, they probably played against each other a ton of times. Whether it be on the ladder or even just in some of these other weekly events and whatnot. He actually cancels the eBay.
Yeah, and mate, what just happened is shocking, by the way.
Already.
Something that just happened is that normally we have the Protoss player, fine, they chrono out a Zella, maybe pull a couple of boys, they deal with the eBay, and then once it's dealt with, then they get their natural base and they throw down some tech. But Firefly, he's like, you know what? You know, you can take my natural, I'll just take my third.
Are you sure we're not watching a PVZ over here, right? That's why I gotta get some Glaive to Depths out real soon and start shading in between.
Oh my god. Like, that's what I mean. Like, this is so... you rarely see this, but again, Firefly, this is what we're talking about. He's young, he's fluid, he's not stuck in his ways, right? Like, he's fine, you know? I'll just take my third. Whatever. Apparently.
And to be honest, what is XY really gonna... How is he XY really going to contest that base? We are on a Romanticide at third base. True. Is very, very defensible. Sure, it's got two potential front lines, but honestly, there you have to go up a ramp on both sides. It doesn't take much for Firefly here.
Yeah, I mean, imagine taking a third or being forced to take your natural as your third base on like one of the other maps, like even Lightshade or one of the more shorter rush distance maps. It can be devastating, but here on Romanticide, it's kind of not the worst thing. You know, we have high ground here on the left hand side, high ground here as well towards the north. Like, it's a very, very defensible location.
You just mentioned Oxide and Lightshade to me, Light, and as a Terran player, I gotta say that is the dream. Tank pushes, oh man.
Yeah, exactly. It'd be terrifying, but you know, it's not the worst thing here for Firefly. You know, he's even being annoying himself. Some adepts do go across the map, denying a bunch of mining here at the natural.
Yeah, a little bit inefficient here for XY, not mining as efficiently as he wants to, I should say. Mm. Interesting choice to go with the reacted Hellions here.
Yeah, definitely, especially because like there's no Reaper with this either. Typically there is, and oh my god, one of the Adepts does shade in.
Does, gets a completely full scout off. This Stalker tries to take a little bit of damage, but one of the Adepts will go down. I think it should still be enough though here. Or Firefly, not enough to get damage done, but definitely enough to scout the base of XY.
Oh yeah, yeah, he saw everything in the main base, knows it's a 1-1-1, know that there isn't a massive commitment into like a Widowmine drop or anything like that. So yeah, very interesting start so far here from both players. Oh my god, these Stalkers are trading so well.
They really are, making absolute best use of their long range.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's been insane. He hasn't lost a single one. I spoke a little too soon. He's gonna lose both.
Yes, all the repairs there by XY. I do think that he very easily could have lost every single one of his Hellions, but thankfully, you know, solid micro, solid repairs as well, able to keep everything alive. And yeah, I imagine this drop, you know, would have been great with a couple more Hellions.
Would have, but here's the thing, like, What about two Hellions and a Viking?
Wait, there's a Viking in there. what is happening right now?
It's one of the funniest mental images ever.
Uh-huh.
You'd imagine a Viking and a medevac to be around the same size.
That Viking has to be so lazy, right? Like, I'm not going to fly myself. I'm going to hop in a goddamn medevac. Okay, I guess so. This is so odd, by the way. So this drop could deal some damage. A Warpin was just used across the map. So Firefly, he's going to have a bit of a hard time defending at home, but he does blink on top of the tank.
And immediately takes it out. There's no wall available over here for XY. No bunkers either. He's got plenty of high ground. Firefly does into the main base of XY. XY's trying to equalize the damage here, but I'm not convinced he's going to get it. Maybe we have the Viking.
Oh my god. Okay, one of the Hellions does get taken out. These Hellions are dealing a lot of damage here, but they will be cleaned up. Meanwhile, on the other side of the map, mates, the tank isn't even sieged.
That it is not. XY does not want to risk a... getting it sniped with a blink, but if he doesn't siege it up, there's just so much less damage he can do.
Yeah, and he's at risk of getting it sniped by a blink, as we see. Oh my god, it goes down!
Mate wasn't even sieged up. Firefly continuing just elevated these stalkers. He doesn't even need to. They have blink!
God. Exactly, they do have blink. Two tanks already going down, 26 SCVs, another massive warp in here. We have a Banshee. Mate, the Banshee does not even have a cloak. And, oh god, the tank, mate, he just can't get the tank up.
Yeah, even if it did, there's already an observer. It's really hard seeing XY pull something off over here. Mm-hmm. GG is called, and Firefly takes game number one.
GG.
GG, well played. That was an unconventional game, to say the least.
Yeah, it was a little bit odd, you know, a bit of a quirky start because XY did force an unnatural natural, but at the same time, we saw Blink was on the way, and yeah, XY did kind of crumble a little bit to the pure Blink Stalker. I don't even think having those Hellions and that Viking at home would have changed anything, to be honest.
Oh, it definitely wouldn't have. Up against that many Blink Stalkers, they do not even need to start kiting. And they have blink.
definitely. And with that, we will be diving straight into game number two after this short break.
Enjoy the messages. And we are back, continuing a very wacky start to our best of three match over here. I have to think back, and I feel like we've barely scratched the surface of how odd that game was, from the unnatural third base to the reacted Hellions into a Viking, to the Viking being landed and lifted.
Yeah, there was a lot that went into that game. I don't know if a lot of value was extracted from that game. it was a lot of fun.
It was. That's what I wanted. That's value to me.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Especially what I wanted to see out of XY here.
Definitely.
Wild card.
I'm a little bit concerned, though, because, again, things just didn't go XY's way there. He didn't really scout his opponent, but hopefully he's able to tighten up here in game number two.
That is going to be the ideal as we continue on to Oxide LE. We're in the top left-hand corner map, starting all the way into the top left-hand corner. The Red Terran player from China, representing Invictus Gaming IG, he is XY.
And spawning in the bottom right-hand corner of Lightshade LE, we have the Chinese Protoss player. He is blue, representing himself. It is Firefly.
Now, could you call it Team Invictus Gaming?
Yeah?
T-I-G!
T-I-
Got it.
That's
Got
not,
it.
That's, I didn't know what I was agreeing to. Oh.
IG.
Are we just gonna force the three letter acronym onto everything? Is that what we're doing?
Look, it's not our fault.
Team Cranky Ducklings TCD. Oh god, I don't think we can do that.
Well, we can't, because at the end of that we have to include a quack, so it'd be like Team CD.
Oh god, we'll figure it out. But I do love this, you know, Firefly in game number two, he's the one who's doing a little bit more annoying. Like, yo, you NG block me? Mate, let me just peck away at your workers.
Yeah, I'm gonna make you pull SCVs. You thought you could just build your bunker? Huh?
Huh? Again. Exactly. And pretty interesting choice. I mean, we have seen this rise in popularity recently in this matchup, where the Terran player kind of, interesting, doesn't go for a Reaper first, but he's still going for the Reaper, though.
Huh. Yes, you were saying, we've been seeing a lot of Reaperless builds come out in TVP recently. Mm-hmm. A lot of time it's focused on an earlier tank push, or maybe something involving Banshees as well, but XY went for the Safety Marine and then is also getting the Reaper. I am keeping my eyes on that SCV going home right now, because I'm not entirely convinced that it's not gonna proxy. XY is a proxying, okay.
Yeah, it's odd. Right? Because again, he opened up, I guess, safe, but like he still wanted to scout anyway, but now the scout is late and delayed, and the chances of this actually scouting is a lot lower because, you know, now there's an Adept, right? And the Adept actually is looking to try and catch that Reaper. Yo, the Reaper's not even going for a scout.
Just looking to catch that Adept in the middle of the map. Should not fight it.
It's one of those things where, mate, you're trying to capture an Adept? Okay, we'll see. I mean, you're with the help of the Marines, though.
Might be able to get it. Mostly just trying to buy time for that bunker. Adept will not be getting into the main base. Not going to be getting much of a delay of anything.
Not quite.
XY's looking pretty safe.
Yeah, he's looking pretty safe so far. He's going for another 1-1-1. We'll see if he tries to go for that, like, Hellion drop again, or if he has something else in mind. Again, like, there's a lot that Terran can do here in the beginning of the game. A lot of different openers, like Widowmine drops, like Banshees. See what XY has in store for us.
That we shall. Looks to be about a more standard sort of Hellion drop. I say that. He only gets a single Hellion.
Yeah. Like, he doesn't go for the switch with the factory and the rack. So again, only one Hellion comes out. He's working on that tech lab. I guess he may even go for a switch here. After
Viking
the...
first again?
Yeah.
XY Mate. Has played against a lot of Blinkstalker openings, hasn't he? Okay, he sees the Stargate.
He saw the Stargate, so this makes sense, right? Oh my god, he's getting everything. He's getting a Cyclone and a Viking to help defend against those Oracles. Meanwhile, ooh, the Hellion, it gets in.
Yeah, XY prioritizing damage here on the mineral line. Does get a little bit done. Of course, a little bit of a distraction here for the Oracle, but no big deal in the end. Buys him a little bit of time to get that Cyclone out, though.
That it does. So XY will have the defenses ready for said Oracle. You know, we have even a second Viking coming out. Yeah, a second Cyclone. Oh my god.
This is starting to feel a little excessive to me. Line, the Viking misses the Oracle!
No, the Oracle does slip past somehow. I mean, okay, it doesn't get into the mineral line. It just throws down a revelation. Oh no.
Interesting. Very good ambush coming out over here for XY. Firefly was not expecting the low ground Cyclone. And that is one less Oracle to worry about. Actually, that is zero Oracles to worry about.
Yeah, interesting decision here from Firefly. He did go for an Oracle first, but immediately went into that Twilight Council, immediately going into Bleakstalkers. Not just that, but after his initial like aggression being thwarted, he throws out a third base.
Which may be at a bit of an awkward timing over here. XY is already looking to push out, looking to punish Firefly with the units he's already built.
Definitely, and with two Cyclones, like, there is so much firepower here. One of the Cyclones does get down to half health, but yo, Firefly is overextending.
So low. Is overextending a little bit. The additional vision from these Vikings actually helps a ton. XY able to maintain that lock on for quite some time. Landing both of them, he wants a lot of DPS, but he does not want to tangle with this army quite yet, which I don't really blame him. I mean, this isn't a very threatening army from Firefly, but you never know what's lurking behind that, right?
It isn't, right? That's why I was assuming maybe XY could take the fight. But after losing his first Cyclone almost immediately, like, that did really push him or pull him back. Also, it was kind of interesting to see how it's like, yo, the Vikings are huge. They're providing high ground vision. And then he lands the Vikings. It's like, oh, okay.
Okay. Like, oh, the Vikings, they're going to do an extra damage against Stalkers over here.
Yeah.
And he doesn't fight.
Exactly. Meanwhile, Firefly, he's just kind of testing the waters here. He does have a reinforcing pylon, but by no means does he intend to push in and try and break this siege, because again, he's got a third, he's probing up.
Yeah, he's sticking outside of that base of XY for now, just making sure he can contain him on two bases. XY, I suppose, is looking to go for a big two base timing and then land the CC as he pushes out, but it seems very delayed.
It very much so does. Again, like, plus one only just starting. Sim only just starting. We're almost 7 minutes into the game. So this time that you're talking about, like, I'm sure he does want to hit it, but it feels very late. Again, like, his initial Cyclones on Vikings kind of delaying himself.
Yeah.
Speaking of...
The Cyclone Viking is really good against Stargate openings, but it seems a little excessive. Oh, forces a warp in his zealots.
Yeah,
it's actually not too bad. Also gets five probes over here.
Yeah, honestly,
nice,
this
bit of damage to slow Firefly down.
Yeah, this Viking harass has been pretty insane so far. I mean, at least he was able to find some damage with them. Unfortunately, both Vikings were taken out. There's only one Viking remaining here, and what's like, this slows down Firefly a little bit, I guess. But now XY is attempting to take his third,
and he will be able to land it and secure it as well. Which, again, I suppose it's just interesting that XY takes the third and actually defends it instead of, you know, taking the third as he pushes out. Well, he can't exactly push out right now, but...
Yeah, I would assume he's going to push out soon, right? Like, all the upgrades, they're kind of lined up. Like, they're going to finish up pretty soon. Like, XY will have maybe a bit of an advantage. I say that, but it is kind of an anti-timing, because by the time XY does get across the map, Storm would be done.
Yeah, I almost feel like the better choice here would be to just go for some drops as he builds up to 2-2 upgrades. Sim is completed, but I feel like if he wanted to push out, he'd already be making his way across the map by now.
Yeah, you would think so. The medevacs finally come out as well, so you can potentially go for those drops, but immediately the medevacs do get tagged, so if he did, Firefly would have eyes on them. You're the tank!
Very, very exposed. Does manage to take it out, Firefly does. And doesn't lose too much to get that. Only a couple Stalkers. Well worth it.
Oh, yeah.
Protoss player.
My mate, the other tank. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Two potential tanks looking very, very exposed. But Firefly is able to get one of them, which is already pretty massive.
Definitely. Meanwhile, XY is finally pushing out across the map here. Ooh, does catch the Oracle. But again, what I'm worried about is... Mate, look at all these High Templar. They're already ready. Mate, they're ready for those storms.
Yeah, did finish up quite some time ago. These Templar have been building up energy.
That they have. Meanwhile, Firefly, now he's starting to diversify his AoE. He's getting a second Verbo. He's getting a Robotics Bay for that double Colossus or double Disruptor production. Things are looking very scary here. I mean, XY, he does have a supply lead, but again, a lot of this is bio and there's a pretty high-tech army here. But you know what? Firefly, he's out of position.
Yeah, there's a pretty high-tech army over here, but not over here.
God, exactly. And Firefly, he responds to the Southern Army, which, I mean, he will be able to fend off. Ooh, the storms do end.
Storms, but the War Prism does get taken out. Most of the High Templar are able to get evacuated. XY losing a lot of the bio over here, but he does take out a base. This Northern Army is still a massive threat. Look at all the probes!
Oh, God, 5 probes go down. The rest of the army for Firefly isn't too far behind. Ooh, I don't believe he has energy for Storm here. So these High Templar were very vulnerable, but an amazing job there by XY.
Yeah, honestly, I was not, I didn't think he'd be able to pull it off, if I'm being honest.
Yeah, again, a lot of this is because of the lack of vision for X4 Firefly. Like, he had a Zealot here towards the south, but he didn't have anything to the north to scout any of these drop potential.
But now that he's sort of dealt with the drops, he is looking to reciprocate the damage. Not going to be able to crack this position, even without the tanks. That is still a bunker. That's still a lot of bio, and that's still a ton of mines.
Oh, God, exactly. We do see Firefly. He is forced back. Thankfully, Enhanced Shockwaves is about to finish up. You know, we have plenty of goes for those EMPs, not just on the main army, but also on the entire Templar. Oh.
Looking at them right now. They're looking pretty vulnerable, but they are behind the foliage. They are unable to be seen right now for XY.
That they are. Meanwhile, now we have a couple of disruptors coming into the fray as well. So again, there will still be AoE even if the army does get EMP'd. Meanwhile, that War Prism has also been remade.
Yeah, was able to protect a couple of these High Templar from EMPs.
Oh no.
XY's going for a mass drop here, Light.
Once again,
Firefly,
there's nothing here.
Firefly does not see it.
Exactly, no vision whatsoever. The drop does get into the main base. Firefly, he's responding, he's forced to recoil.
And honestly, how much damage can XY really get done over here before that happens? Most of the ghosts get taken out over here by that Disruptor. That is already a huge gain over here. EMP's unable to damage the energy of the High Templar.
Exactly. I mean, there was some nice focus fire there by XY. He did actually focus down the War Prism, but all the High Templar were evacuated before it went down. Decent trade either way, but again, as we saw, there were a lot of ghosts that went down there.
There were, but that was all the High Templar. Sure, there are a couple of Archons left, and XY has to be very, very careful about the Disruptors.
Definitely.
But if he pushes out right now, he should be able to get some damage done, take at least one base.
Mm-hmm. What I'm worried about is, like, again, this is a very strong army, but it's here towards the south, and we see another run by here towards the north, and once again, Firefly sees nothing here. He's throwing down a pylon now, but it's too late.
Well, it's especially too late now that the probe that was going to build it has gone down.
Exactly. Interesting decision. Yeah, DTs do get morphed in. Most of them get taken out, but the army is not too far behind. It looks like this Nexus may get saved.
It may not, but in the end, XY is going to lose his army over here. Even if he does, take out that Nexus, turn it down!
Oh. Nexus is saved. At the same time, the drop is headed towards that natural base. I believe recoil is still on cooldown, and yo, XY, he may have not gotten the base towards the north, but maybe he can get the natural. The Forge!
Eventually, the Forge does get taken out, and being this far behind on upgrades as a Protoss player, last thing you want in a PBT. XY looking to secure the high ground, does take out the Templar Archives. No more High Templar for quite some time over here.
Oh, the Warpism!
Firefly, the Warpism is looking to get targeted out, and it does!
Oh my god.
Taking out with it. So many EMPs are landing.
Exactly. Meanwhile, we have a couple of disruptor shots, and it looks like they just make it past the Protoss army. I was a little bit scared there, but Firefly does clean this up, but the damage has been done, and yo, another drop came in, and he finished off the Nexus.
XY, really the master of the multi-prong over here. Been doing so well to avoid a big main army engagement. And it's working out tremendously. 30 probes went down here, Light. And let me tell you something about Protoss. They don't have mules.
They do not have mules. They have Chrono, but it's nowhere near as good, especially when it comes to the economy. And here we go. Firefly is going across the map. He is 100% all in. Can he win a head-on engagement? Maybe, with disruptor shots. But again, he has to be careful not to get them sniped. Oh.
He really does. That's why, meanwhile, a little bit scary over there. Almost engaged without borrowing his mines. Last thing he wants to happen. No detection in these bases, like, oh no.
May,
it's
we're
a
going.
Chart, but it's a little bit out of position.
May, we're going full base trade. Beautiful disruptor shots there as the base does go down, and XY, he's just going across them. He recalls! What?
Oh no. This may not be the best time to recall. A couple of good feedbacks on top of the ghost. Purification Novas are decent, and the storms are able to zone out the bio, but look at that supply difference right now, like. I'm not sure if XY realizes it though.
Exactly, and where is the detection? Observer is on the way, but yo, it's gonna be close. These, yo, the window lights, they're gonna reset, Oh my god!
They're looking to reset. Is there gonna be enough damage? Just about enough. Okay. A second later, and this army would have been toast.
It would have been disastrous, mate. That was like, what, 5-6 Widow Mines? Jesus Christ. And now, yo, because of the damage that was done, like, things are evening out a little bit.
Yeah, XY really let go of his advantage over there.
Mm-hmm.
Could have went straight for the throat and won the game, but now the supplies are evening out. Firefly has a bit of a better army. XY... it's also a very good defensive position. Firefly does not want to throw away his high-tech army to this! Purification Novas! One of them does land!
Ooh, exactly.
And it was one of the juiciest hits you could have gotten.
Mm-hmm. So many Marauders just went down in that Purification Nova. The majority of the Ghosts did survive, and now we have Liberators. Not just Liberators, but Liberator range as well. Meanwhile, DTs are disrupting the economy. 14 SCVs went down.
Of course, there's a scan out, which every single scan that's being used right now for XY is a mule that's not being dropped.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Meanwhile, yo, this army does get spotted. Oh my god, it gets stormed upon!
And as Zealots chase them down, completely avoids the Liberators and the Stalkers deal with the rest. Radiation Novas not quite able to land.
I mean, mate, they landed on the last ghost. All the ghosts have been taken out here. Meanwhile, there's a drop here towards the north. Oh my god, a random Colossus got picked off!
Wow. Oh, he's going to be watching rallies. Hmm. And XY, he will be able to take out this base, but again, it feels like Firefly has suddenly found the advantage once again.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I believe, if I'm not wrong, yeah, I just checked. Zero ghosts out on the map right now. Just a Bio Liberator and a couple of tanks. Meanwhile, yo, this Mortar Hit Squad is getting so much damage on the second base.
We're getting in a scenario where neither player can give up their bases right now. Firefly wants nothing more than to take out this Orbital Command. Not only is it going to be able to mine, it's got plenty of mule energy, plenty of scans on it.
Oh my god, and the shrub shots do go off. The tanks get taken out. There are still a couple of Liberators here on the back line, and really that's what's keeping XY alive, but the CC goes down.
And that was just about the last hopes, I fear, for XY. DTs being used defensively. Such a good utility for DTs.
Well, I love it because, like, the amount of orbitals that are out on the map, like, there's two. There's the main, which is trying to land at the fourth, and there's the natural, like, orbitals and mules are so important right now. That scan energy, meanwhile, oh my god, the storms!
Juiciest storms, oh no, XY! Little bit of a rally issue over there, running back into the storm.
Meanwhile, mate, these Marauders, they've been through hell, they've killed two Nexuses and they're still alive.
Yo, Firefly is starting to really run out of money. He's got plenty more workers, but less bases. His bases are about to be mined out right now.
And I don't know if this is the right move here for XY. He's exposing all of his Liberators. His Liberators are the backbone of his army right now. To be fair, this is a really awkward position, and Bleachstalkers are going to have a hard time cleaning this up.
They really, really will. The probe's a long distance mining right now.
He gives up on it, mate. He's like, fuck. I'm not messing with that, mate. Ah!
I bet Firefly hopes more than anything right now that Nexus could be lifted.
Mm-hmm. If only, mate. If only. So now, basically, zero mining here from Firefly. Firefly, he's trying to catch that drop of Marauders. Meanwhile, he's going straight towards that planetary. That planetary is not long for this world. There's nothing here to protect it. Oh, no! The drop!
It is the freshest mining base. The drop does pick it out there, but this planetary fortress does not. The freshest base of XY. He actually had a bit of an income advantage earlier on. It's completely lost it now.
Definitely. Meanwhile, that drop is coming back into the main base. This time, there are units here to defend, so Firefly should be perfectly fine. Meanwhile, here comes the main army. What is there to defend? This is what I was talking about. The Liberators are out on the map. They're not here to protect the bases.
That they are not. XY actually having to unseize and go all the way back home, but I fear it may already be too late. And again, over in these positions, there's a lot less dead air to take advantage of.
Mm-hmm. But what's important is the economy. Right now, XY, he's actually mining. He has a base. Firefly doesn't. He has, again, he's long distance mining. From his natural base, that is it. He's struggling so much to deal with these liberators. The liberators are out of position though. They don't see shot.
That they are not.
Ooh.
Get them all into the light over here. My Firefly can just continue to do this whole song and dance. Every time he forces a re-siege up here from XY, you just go a different direction. Now, the Liberator has been cleaned out in Firefly's base, so
finally
he's able to mine again.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. I would just love him to repower this Stargate and get a Void Ray. Like, one Void Ray. Like,
it's an anti-air, I just realized.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, Liberators, I guess, but, like, their anti-air is pretty god-awful, to be honest. It would do so well here. Oh, Storms on the Libs!
Well, who says that Firefly doesn't have anti-air?
Oh my god, and here we go.
Storms, all you really need. Very good snipes here from the Stalkers. Every Liberator that XY loses hurts him so much more than every Stalker Firefly does.
Exactly, exactly. And here we go. Finally, XY proactively re-sieging his Liberators, making it difficult for Firefly to really find an angle. But he does. The Mules.
A couple of SCVs actually giving up the position of this orbital command will go down, and with it, all of XY's hopes of victory.
Yeah, only one orbital left, and if I was Firefly, I would warp in like one DT, send it in, force a scan, send another DT, you know, just keep sending them in, keep just disrupting the economy of XY, because this is it, this is his only base.
Yeah, he has enough for one DT. Okay, going for the Stalkers right now. Actually going for another Nexus.
Yeah,
wisely done.
Like, his economy is actually getting back into the swing of things. Like, as we can see, things are evening up with those resources. And oh god, XY, he can't just be stuck defending here. He has a lot of Liberators, mate. Send him out, you know, again, like, start hurting that economy just like before. He's just had tunnel visioning a little bit, and here comes the DT.
My face is wide open right now, like my mouth, I mean. In
my
horror.
Face, my mouth, my mouth, is every, it's all open, mate, it's all open.
Just like this base of XY, we're getting to the point where there's just too much beef in this army. Every single Liberator is going to go down.
There it is, it's just too much here. XY sends his last remaining forces across the map, but mate, this is his last orbital. This is it for XY, as try as hard as he might. Mate, the DTs come in, there's no scan.
None whatsoever, no detection available. GG is called.